Hi everyone, this is Unit 4 and we are discussing now the simple harmonic motion. The simple harmonic motion. So let's begin. Now, what exactly is this type of motion? What is the difference between this type of motion and any other motion? A simple harmonic motion is one where there are certain conditions. One is, for example, if I take a spring and if I allow the spring to oscillate from this position, which is also the zero displacement, let us say I elongate him down till this position, which is x max, but it is negative, okay? And then if I let him go, he will oscillate back by compressing itself up to this position, which is the x, again max, maximum, but then this one is now positive. So the spring oscillates from zero displacement to max, zero, max, and then again zero. This is called one cycle. So if I have to plot that, between the displacement it is making, and the time it takes, then I could get any type of curve. Maybe I can get a sine curve. So this is a sine curve, okay? Maybe I could also get a cos curve, you know, something like this, still for the x and t. Of course, t is in seconds, x is in centimeter or meter or whatever you want to keep the unit here, as a unit. Now, at this point in the equilibrium, at this point, which is also your equilibrium, we have the velocity component maximum. And here, where the displacement is maximum, the velocity component is zero. Again, up here, the velocity component is zero. Now, if velocity is zero, how come the spring, how come this object again comes back? Now, that is because you have your force, which is maximum, which also means that your A, the acceleration, that is also maximum. See? So acceleration is maximum here. Here your force is zero. Let us say the acceleration is zero. And then here again the acceleration is maximum. Now what do we understand from this? From these we understand one thing, that A is proportional to x. And that is not just the case. A is also equal to some constant k times x. Now this also doesn't satisfy the equation completely, because the force and displacement are opposite, so we write the equation now as A equal to minus kx. So we have an equation here, A is equal to minus kx. What does this equation mean to us? This equation simply means that if I plot a graph, if I happen to plot a graph between my A and my X, the gradient would be negative. So the graph would go possibly this nature, see? So if I have to go here and if I have to go here, then these are my maximum displacement on either side, right? So these are my maximum displacement. Okay, now let us also analyze something more here. The equation of simple harmonic motion is written as x equal to x naught sine omega t, and or let us say x equal to x naught cos omega t. Now from where do we get this omega? We know that omega, is nothing but the angle per unit time. Now if that is true, then in that case, for one rotation, if we make one rotation, then we are going to have here your theta itself as 360 degree. Now that is very interesting. See, if the theta is 360 degree, then it also means that 2π radian. So now the omega can be written as your 2π/T. Now what does this equation itself mean? Now omega is equal to 2π/T. See, frequency is 1/T, right? So we can write this equation as 2πf. Now this is also known as your angular frequency. So if you look at this equation here, omega is equal to theta by t, then I can write for this equation as your theta is equal to omega into t, and that is the reason why your sine theta is written as sine omega t, and your cos theta is written as cos omega t. Okay, is written as cos omega t. Now let us proceed. So this is the basic idea that we have now with us, all right? And if we look at the spring, because we all know that the energy that the spring possesses actually comes from your Hooke's law, where Hooke's law clearly states that the force is directly proportional to the displacement. So we also write Hooke's law, which is F equal to kx, and then we write the work done by the spring, which is half kx square. Okay, so if you remember, there were two equations, and then we write the energy as your half kx square. Okay, now if we have the energy as half kx square, then we also understand is equal to half kx square. Now if I have to draw the energy curve for this, then what exactly I am going to do now? So the energy curve will be something that has both the potential and the kinetic. So if the spring makes a maximum displacement, and then I get the displacement as x maximum, I can draw the energy graph as your like this. Now if you look here at the peak here, now that is the maximum energy, and that is also the total energy of the system, which means at the peak here I am going to have a line, right, like this. Let's say if this happens to be your kinetic energy, then your potential energy would be just the other way around, because we know that when kinetic energy is max, the potential energy is zero. So we can easily now draw something like this, you see, like this, and this line is your potential energy, and exactly at the center, if we look at this point here at the center, now that is the equilibrium point. Okay, sorry, my bad. So at the center we have a position where the potential energy is equal to kinetic energy. Anyway, now comes the condition that we were looking for, that what exactly are the conditions for simple harmonic motion. Now conditions are, there are two conditions here we have, and the conditions are something like this. The first condition says that A is proportional to x. So the conditions are A is proportional to x. And then we also have another condition. And this condition is regarding the acceleration. We now know that the acceleration is always directed towards the equilibrium. See, if you look very carefully, then this oscillation had the acceleration from top moving down here at the equilibrium, and again from bottom here to the top here, equilibrium. So the acceleration was always directed towards equilibrium. So these two are the main conditions that we have for simple harmonic motion. Okay. Okay, so A is towards center. Right. Now, this is all fine. So, this 4.1 is now over here. So, this was only 4.1 just. So, let me just put the label number and then I will close this. Okay, the pen seems to be a little bit not working well. That's the reason why it's getting delayed in my voice. Okay, so whenever we solve these sort of questions related to these, they're basically at, you have to apply the concept that you have now understood in these small applications. So simple harmonic motion, the type of curves you have, and then you have your graph, basic graph, and then you have your angular speed or velocity, and then you have your angular frequency, which is in terms of frequency f, and then you have your total energy in the system, and then you are looking at the graphs here for a relation between acceleration and displacement, and then the graph for your energy. That's it for this 4.1. Thank you.